So after the Concord ruling, the ANC said that they would like to have a press conference where the president addresses the nation at 7 p.m. on a Friday night. So Jacob Zuma walks to the podium, he looks square at the camera and goes, "April fools, bitches." Hey, what's up guys, it's Lendi here. So this video will be focusing on the Constitutional Court report regarding Nkandla and also on Jacob Zuma's public response to that. Now, yes, trust me, I'm getting just as sick and tired of this man as you are. And constantly reporting on this man makes me want to high-five myself in the face with a brick. But he literally is causing so many WTF moments that I have to talk about it. Alright, so with that being said, let's focus on the Concord ruling. The Constitutional Court is the highest court in the land. On the Nkandla matter, the Constitutional Court made three very important findings. Firstly, Jacob Zuma and the National Assembly failed to uphold, respect and defend the Constitution as the supreme law of the land. Yes, ANC MPs, that means you too. Secondly, they found that Zuma will have to pay back the money. Now, how much is it? We will know soon enough. Thirdly, and most importantly, the public protector's roles are now clearly defined, and I can assure you that nobody's going to mess with that department anytime soon. So in a nutshell, South Africa won and Zuma's ANC lost. So this is obviously great news for South Africa and its democracy, because we know now that the opposition parties will definitely do something to try and impeach the president again. And they really have great grounds to do this on, because Jacob Zuma and his ANC failed to uphold, respect and defend the Constitution. So you are probably going, "We tried to impeach him before, nothing's going to change. Once we try and impeach him this time, the same thing will happen." Well, let's be real. There probably won't be an impeachment, but there is method to this madness. You need to understand that a lot of people go, they do not vote for Jacob Zuma. They vote for the organization, which means they vote for the organization and not the individual. But by forcing the ANC MPs to support Zuma and back him and keep him as the president, what they are basically saying is that the ANC supports the individual, therefore the individual is the organization. Does that make sense? Now, with all of that being said, let's focus on the second part of this video, which focuses on Zuma's April Fool's speech. After the Concord ruling, the ANC asked the president to address the nation. Now, we were definitely very skeptical, but there was a little bit of hope that something wonderful might happen. Most South Africans wanted to hear the following. "Dear South Africans, I am sorry I have failed you as the president. I will pay back every single cent I owe and I will resign with immediate effect. I hope that with time you can forgive me and put your trust in the ANC once again." But of course, instead of hearing that glorious speech, what we had to endure for 21 minutes was him saying that he was not to blame. He was always going to pay back the money as soon as people could just tell him how much he needed to pay back. Yeah, right. But with all of that being said, we expected it. But I would like to focus on one thing quickly. I get that English isn't the president's first language. Hell, it's not even my first language. But with that being said, he speaks English quite well when he doesn't read it from a piece of paper. He also wears glasses, so we know there's nothing wrong with his eyes while reading. So whilst listening to the speech on the 1st of April, I noticed something quite peculiar. He turns those pages in front of him quite often whilst saying so little. So I started to count how many words he actually reads before he turns the page. It turns out it's really, really short. Now, if you don't believe me, just check out the link in the description below. So how bad is it really? This is what the international standard is roughly when it comes to reading speeches. The font is Arial and the font size is between 16 and 18. In this instance, it's 18. And this is what Jacob Zuma's speeches look like. It's an Arial font and the font size is 45. So just to compare the two, international standard, Jacob Zuma. Now that really shouldn't piss me off, but it does, because we know that Jacob Zuma speaks English quite well, and we know that Jacob Zuma has no problems with his eyes because he wears glasses. So therefore, it means that his reading capability just isn't good enough. The president of this country should be educated and should be well versed, because they need to look after 54 million people. They need to protect them and keep them safe. Zuma needs to go, and he needs to go now. We need to do this for the sake of South Africa and everybody that resides in it. South Africa can be such a better place, and all we need to do is get rid of Zuma and Zuma's ANC. And that's basically all I've got to say. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to share it with your friends and family, because that's the only way my message gets out there. Be sure to leave a comment and thank you for watching. Till later, cheers and peace out.
Ah.